more later about the options for what to do for a roller. Another pro tip is if you want to get a roller, is you can that's inexpensive. They're pretty much now, you can get them at $5 stores, but you can go to Home Depot and have them cut you PVC pipe that is about, what did you say, 5-6 inches wide and about 3 foot in length, and it costs about $2.30. And you can use that as a foam roller, and it works just as well as this. So I really highly recommend it if you're one of those people that likes full body massages. I mean, who doesn't? But you can't maybe afford it or don't have the time for massage. This is one way to get the positive effects of a full body massage in your own home. So again, for $2.30, you can get that from home, but we will make modifications when we come to that at the end of class. So to begin, let's go ahead and sit on top of our surface that is bolster-like. And you're just going to allow the legs to fall in front of you. Again, you want to have that sensation that you have one heel directly in front of the other. It'll feel a little bit awkward, possibly, but just try to do it anyway. One of your knees might be higher than the other. Good, and then sit up nice and tall. You'll notice right away that this alleviates any kind of tension in the hips that you find from normally sitting in easy pose. So sit up tall, chest lifted, shoulders back and down. Good. Reach the crown of your head up toward the ceiling and bring the back of the palms so that they're facing up toward the ceiling. Inhale through the nose, lift the crown of your head higher. Exhale, soften the shoulders down away from the ears, keeping the head and neck long and lifted. Inhale, fill the belly and chest with air. Exhale, release the air from the body, soften in the belly, the abdomen, the ribs. Another inhale, lift the crown of the head up toward the ceiling. Exhale, melt the entire body around that spine into softness. Let's just begin with a nice twist. Go ahead and take your left hand to the outside of your right thigh, and your right hand can come onto your surface, or if you can reach the floor with yoga fingertips, you can press down and in. You may also place a block behind you if you need that hand elevated. We don't want to lean back in the spine, okay? So use your bolster, your block, or the floor. Come around belly first, then the chest, then the chin. Every time you inhale, continue to lengthen in the spine, growing in the tailbone, engage your abs. Inhale, roll those shoulders up. Exhale, relax them back and down. Inhale, bring your hands into prayer position. Exhale, relax the shoulders back and down. Inhale, stretch those arms up. And exhale, fold. Let it go. Hang like a rag doll. Inhale, yoga fingers look up. Good, you're trying to get that cow belly going. Exhale, fold, hang like a rag doll again. Inhale, step your right leg back and hold this lunge, exhaling. Just stay here in this lunge. Inhale. Exhale, drop those hips down. Keep breathing. If you need blocks underneath your hands, because you can't quite get those yoga fingertips down, place blocks down there. If it's hard on your wrists, you can press into fists if you need to do that to hold yourself there. And go ahead and inhale. Exhale, hop that left leg back and hold your plank. Exhaling, stay in your plank. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale, one more inhale, and then exhale down, knees, chest, chin, come down in a reverse push-up. Inhale, baby cobra. Good, keep your toes untucked and just gently come up with the chest, not too much, only as far as you can without lifting, with lifting those hands. It'll come up too high as we're still warming up the spine. Good, look up to where the wall and ceiling meet, opening in the throat. Exhale, press into your hands and come into down dog. Beautiful, relax through the head and neck. Make any adjustments you need in those feet, coming forward with them or back as needed. Relax that head and neck and tuck your armpits in towards your rib cage. Here's your flaring out just a little bit, Patrick. Tuck them in and down and push those shoulder blades down to your bum. Very nice. Head and neck relax. If you need to take a break and come to pose of the child, do. Dominique, walk your feet forward. Oh, not Dominique, sorry. Walk your feet forward just a little bit. Nice deep breathing here. Inhale, look up. Hop that right leg forward and let's hold that lunge. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Look down at the space between your thumbs. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. On your next exhale, hop that left leg forward and hold. There you go. Relax the head and neck. Hang like a ragdoll. Inhale, yoga fingers look up. Exhale, fold. Let it all hang. Good. Inhale, reverse swan dive. Arms come up first. Hands together. Exhale, prayer position. Very nice. Are you warm? Feel that? Okay. Any questions on that? Your questions help the people at home. Does anybody feel like they need blocks? If you were using your fists, then go grab blocks. Go grab two blocks or two. Yeah, go grab them. You might even use blocks. You know, I know you have one. Will you grab an extra one? Okay, grab three. So when you're in your lunge, come to your lunge, and I'll show why. You're using yoga fingertips, great, but flatten your palm. Good. Isn't that better? A little?
Yeah.
And then that way you don't have to necessarily put pressure into your fingertips unnecessarily. It's that... my mat. I'm surfing on my mat. Come back into your prayer position at the front of your mat. Great work, everyone. Okay. Good. Tighten through calves and thighs. Tuck the tailbone. Engage the abs. Inhale, roll those shoulders up. Exhale, relax them back and down. Good. Inhale, stretch those arms up. Exhale, fold. Hang like a rag. Inhale, yoga fingers, look up. Good. Exhale, fold. Inhale, hop that right leg back into your lunge. Use your blocks if you want to. Good. Breathe normally here. Relaxing that right hip down to the floor. You want to feel this lunge. So there you're overstretching, right? Yes, you can. So I want you to really push into your heel and lift that right knee up. That's another one where you're getting that. Okay, push into that floor. Push the floor away from you with the foot, like you're building strength right now rather than flexibility, because you've got the flexibility. All right. Inhale. Exhale, drop the left leg back. Okay, and hold your plank with a nice deep inhale. And exhale, staying in plank. Inhale. So just before, keep breathing, I was telling a student over here who's become very flexible by doing this class that she needs to work on not overstretching. So I want her to start working on building her strength. That's what I was just talking to her about. So instead of being as flexible as she can be and pushing her body possibly too far and getting hurt, I want her to work on pushing the floor away from her in these positions to build strength rather than taking the full stretch, even though she can. All right, you guys are like, stop talking and move us out of this plank. I can feel it. All right, inhale, exhale, knees, chest, chin, come down. Inhale, cobra, come up a little higher. You're nice and warm, so you can come up a little higher, but that's fine. Toes are untucked, legs and butt are relaxed. Good, exhale, press into down dog. Take this as your nice, relaxing down dog. Head and neck relaxed. Good, tuck those armpits in toward your ribs. That's better, good. You could even walk your feet in a couple inches more. Kelsey, walk your feet back just a little bit more. I know it's gonna challenge you, but it'll hit. Yeah, there you go. Maybe not so deep in the upper body. Yeah, right there, perfect. Head just relaxes and hangs. Very nice, everyone. Very, very nice. Press into your palms. Press into your toes. Inhale, look up. Hop your right leg forward and let's hold that lunge. Use your blocks if you need to. You want your right knee directly over your right heel. Good. And again, Kelsey, push your heel to the back of the room. There you go. You can even scoot your toes back. Really nice. You guys are like, I like it better when you practice.
Because then you don't pick on us as much.
Oh, I love it, honestly. Okay, good, good, good. All right. Looking down at the space between your thumbs. This is your hip stretch right now. But you're also working on pushing the floor away from you and breathing deeply. Inhale, hop that left leg forward and hang like a rag doll. In fact, hold on to opposite elbows so you have a little increased weight there. And just sway gently to the left with an inhale, gently to the right with an exhale. Left inhale. Keep that going, right. Let a little something extra go in the spine. Come back to center. Inhale, yoga fingers, look up. Exhale, fold. Inhale, reverse swan dive. And exhale, prayer position. Beautiful. All right, stay there. Inhale, stretch the arms up. Exhale, fold. Inhale, yoga fingers, look up. Exhale, fold. Inhale, step your right leg back. Good. Exhale, lift up. Keep your left arm forward and your right arm back. Good. press your right heel down to the floor and your right toes to the long edge of the mat. Beautiful. Drop your right arm back towards your right thigh. Lift your left arm up and over. And look toward the ceiling if that's okay with your head and neck. Holding it, you're trying to press your mat in opposite directions with your feet, splitting it right down the middle. The more you engage fully through the legs, the more balance you'll feel. Good, now let's straighten the left leg. Bring our arms to parallel to the floor. Left arm is in front, right arm is in back. And I want you to twist, but bring your shoulder down to your left hip rather than reaching. And bring your left hand on top of your left leg, but not on the knee, above or below the knee. We don't want to put the pressure right on the knee joint, above or below. And look up towards your right hand. Very nice. Now, if you need a block here, you would stack it right underneath your left hand in front of your left foot. But the option of placing that left hand on the left leg above or below the knee really helps. And if you're feeling imbalanced, that's when you need to really press your feet in opposite directions. All right, we're just going to windmill those arms back up. Good, bend into your left knee, and then windmill the arms forward back to your left lunge. Slide the left leg back and hold it in plank. Inhale, right knee to left elbow, and exhale it back. Inhale, left knee to right elbow, exhale it back. Keep it going at that nice, slow pace. Abs engaged. Breath is deep. If you need to take a break, drop the knees. Come back when you're able. Three more total. Inhale to one side and back, nice and slow. Inhale to the other side and back. Inhale and back. Good. Drop down. Knees, chest, chin. Inhale, cobra. Good. Hold it there and breathe. Look up to where the wall and ceiling meet. Press your hips down into the floor. Hands are pressed firmly into the floor. Arms as straight as possible. Good. Exhale, press down and in, lifting the bottom, tucking the toes, come into down dog. Beautiful. Relax through the head and neck. Again, if you need a break, take your break. Pose of the child. Listen to your body. Tuck those armpits in towards your rib cage. Work on pressing those heels down into the ground. Feet hip width apart, people. There you go. Good. Bicycle your knees if you need to. Head and neck relaxed. Beautiful, Sharon. Your hands slipping. I have a trick for that later. I'll remind you after class. If your hands slip a lot, in class, you can use chalk. You can place a towel there that's half on the mat, half off the mat. But we actually have chalk in the other classroom. And we have wrist lifts too, so we can work on that. And it is not your only problem. A lot of people have a problem with their hands slipping on their mat. Okay, so that is not unique to you. Inhale, look up, hop the right leg forward. Exhale. Lift those arms up. Right arm comes up, left arm comes in back, and press your left heel down. Left toes point to the long left edge of your mat. Very nice. Now we're going to drop our left arm back and down. Right arm comes up. Fan those ribs up toward the sky. Look toward the ceiling if it's okay with your head and neck. Left arm can rest, left hand can rest on the back of your left leg. Side angle. Push those feet in opposite directions. Right foot pushing forward, left foot pushing back. Now we're going to come forward, bring those arms parallel to the floor, straighten the right leg. If you need that block in front of your right leg, go ahead and place it there. Otherwise, drop your right shoulder down to that right leg, hand above or below the knee. Left fingertips reach up straight for the sky. Very nice. Good use of the block there. Head and neck are nice and long. You want to imagine that your body is between two panes of glass, one right in front of you, one right behind the back, the leg, the foot. Really, really nice. Again, push those feet in opposite directions. Great. Inhale, press off of that leg, come back with the arms parallel to the floor, and then we're going to bend that right knee, bring the hands down, hop that left leg forward from the lunge, and fold. Hang in your ragdoll position, holding on to opposite elbows, and just rock to the left, rock to the right. Keep that going. At your own nice, slow pace. Adjust as needed. All right, so we've pretty much turned our bodies over to the right. We want to turn everything back so that it's facing in the direction of the long edge of the mat. Chest, shoulders, belly, and hips. Also, your right hip is dropping down, so lift that right hip up so that it's level with the left hip. Good. Take your fingertips right in front of the breastbone. Inhale, stretch the arms out to the sides without lifting your shoulders up. Good. Bend your right knee. Excellent. And then go ahead and drop your right elbow on top of your right knee. Palm faces up, left arm reaches up and over. Reach up and over. So you want to have a nice long line from the outside of that left foot through the body, up through that hand. Good. Really feel that stretching sensation across and through the body. Now, everyone drop to their block, left hand down to the block. All right, right hand. Yes, that helps, right, Annalie? Yeah, you're like, this is now a twist. This is now very different. Okay, and good, Sergio, using a fist if you need it. Okay, or you could stack two blocks if you need two blocks there. Push your feet in opposite directions. That's gonna give you all that muscle engagement in the legs. Okay, good. Mabel, I'm gonna lift you like this. Yeah, there we go. Good. Now take that elbow back on top of the right. Yes, knee, perfect. Palm faces up on the right hand. Excellent.
go ahead and come up and out of that. Straighten your right leg and relax your hands down. All right, let's do the other side. Bring your block to the other side. So if you found that you didn't need your block quite so high, you can adjust it to a flatter plane, or if you're super bendy, you might not need the block at all, and you can just rest your hand right down on the floor. All right, the main thing is you want to be able to stay between two panes of glass. When you come down to the floor with your hand, even if you can make it, if that pushes your chest forward and your booty back, then it's not worth it. We want to stay between those two panes of glass, if that makes sense. Okay, so let's try this side. We're going to make all those adjustments, look down at the feet, check the alignment of the heel to the arch, turn those right toes in, that heel is back, push toward the back right corner of the mat, left hip is as high as right hip, good, chest, belly, face all forward to the long edge of the mat, fingertips come to right in front of the chest, inhale, the arms open, good, exhale, bend the left knee, inhale again, reach the crown of the head up, exhale, left elbow on top of left thigh, reach that right arm up and slowly over. Good. Both palms very active and open. Looks good. Left knee should be directly over that left heel. You got it. It's perfect. Reach that arm over like you're trying to touch the wall across the room. Very nice. Good, good, good. Okay. Looking straight ahead or up at your hand. Neutral head position or up at the ceiling. Drop that left hand on top of your block now. Yes, very nice. Good, Sharon, you are like right in between those knees and legs. Looks really good. Nice, looking up underneath your armpit toward the ceiling. Good, lift that arm up a bit more, Mabel, to where the bones will meet. Very nice. Split that mat in two. Really engage your legs here. All right, let's come back with the left arm on top of the left thigh. Keep pushing the floor away from you like you're trying to lift off like a rocket from the floor. All right, now let's bring those arms up. And straighten the left leg. Very nice. Relax the arms down. And go ahead and hop your left leg to the right. Very nice work. Okay. Let's come down to a seated position. Great standing work, everyone. And I'd like to try something with our blocks to work on our leg flexibility. Now this won't be for everyone. So if you start in butterfly position and hold that, if it causes you any sharp pain whatsoever, then just stick with this position, okay? If you're able to, bring your block up underneath those feet and hold on to the soles of the feet. It looks more painful than it is. But this really will help you get a deeper level of flexibility. Everybody okay? Okay, good. Try to lift the chest and relax the shoulders back and down. We're actually just gonna hold this for a little while. If it bothers you to hold on to the feet, if that causes you any pain whatsoever, then just lay back into your hands and let gravity, let those legs hang, okay? So close your eyes. And let's just feel where you're feeling this stretch. Try not to let holding on to the feet take too much of the gravity, weighting those knees down toward the floor, away from the stretch. We want to feel the stretch. We want to feel your sit bones pressed into the floor. I feel like this one is so beneficial because it really works throughout the entire leg and hip structure.
nice deep breathing here. Again, if you start to feel pain, lower back, lumbar, whatsoever, please do press into those hands and just relax like this. It'll become a different stretch, but it'll protect your body.
Perfect idea.
If you don't have a block, you can sit at the bottom of stairs to get this same sensation. Good idea. All right, so we're gonna move into pigeon because I had a request for pigeon. So remember, in pigeon pose, we're getting a nice deep glute and hamstring stretch. If you feel like your flexibility is limited, have a blanket or that bolster nearby to use. So I'm gonna use you as the support. Let's start in all fours position. I'm gonna use you as the model here. All right, so go ahead and slide your right knee forward and your left leg back. Now Patrick's pretty flexible, so he's able to wiggle that right heel forward, but if he wasn't, you'd wanna keep that right heel underneath the right butt cheek. Now, you're gonna drop your upper body forward and rest on your forehead. All right, good. Again, if you're not quite able to get that right heel forward, just keep your right heel under the right butt cheek and place a pillow or blanket underneath the left hip for support and rest down. You will build the flexibility to be able to come deeper into this. If you can't quite get your forehead down to the floor, place that bolster underneath your forehead. You want to be relaxed. Yeah, Sergio, I'll get you your bolster. There you go. Yeah. Good. Did you get a bolster? Oh, you got it. So you want to melt here. This is kind of the epitome of putting your body in a position and letting gravity do the work for you, because this is such a deep stretch. And we're nice and warm after about 35, 40 minutes of movement, stretching those legs, engaging the muscles. So we're in the perfect place for this stretch. As you find that release comes in the hamstring, in the glute, you can release more of the upper body down, or even wiggle that right heel up and more forward toward the short end of the mat. It is key that you stay on top of your left thigh, left knee, left foot. We don't want to roll that leg out for a lot of reasons. Nice work, everyone. Just breathe into it. Become like a puddle. Body as you scan the body from your head down through the back. See if there's any place you're holding tension or tightness, and breathe a softening energy into that place. Keep scanning down through the back lower body, the hips, the bum, your legs, and even your feet. Sometimes we're holding tension in our face or clenching our jaws, clenching the fingertips. Release and let go. Beautiful. Press into your hands. Now we're going to come out of this slowly. Lift the upper body up. Good. Slide that right leg back and the left leg forward. Let's come in and out of three cat and cow movements. Inhale, cow. Exhale, cat back. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. And back to a flat back. All right, let's bring the other leg up. Left leg slides forward, right leg slides back. Wiggle that heel forward if you're able to. Good, make sure you're staying on top of the right thigh, knee, and foot. We're Relax the upper body down. Find a nice soft surface, either your hands or a bolster or a pillow to rest your head on. This side may or may not be more or less flexible. Good. Let those hips just be magnetic to the floor.
Sitting.
you're still going to get a lot of benefit from doing the acupressure engagement with your rounded spine and head pressed into the inner eyebrows, or the corners of the thumb, the thumbs into the corners of the inner eyebrows. Just breathe deeply here as you round that spine even more. Stretching, expanding the spine in all directions. Relieving pressure in the sinuses. Relax your head and neck down and just hang in that ragdoll position, and then cross your elbows so that you're holding on to opposite elbows, deeply stretching in the back of the legs, bending the knees if you need to. And if it feels good to you, sway to the left, sway to the right, sway left. And then let those arms hang, and we're going to slowly stack the spine one section at a time, saving our head and neck for the last bit. Okay. So we're a little short on time for doing quite what I wanted to do with the rollers. So what I would like to offer for you, if you do have a roller at home, and these are pretty nice and long, is that you try final relaxation on a roller. You don't have to do it, but if you have trouble with posture and a rounded spine, then this is a great opportunity to use your roller to help undo and kind of unravel those issues. So what you would do is sit down at the lowest part of your bolster. Again, you'd want to have about a 3 foot long one. You can also do this by laying on top of a ball, like a dodgeball. If you have a kid around that has a dodgeball or even a basketball, and you place that right underneath your shoulder blades. This isn't for everybody, so if you don't enjoy it, don't do it. You want to make sure that your head is supported. And again, if it doesn't feel good to have your head resting right on this bolster, especially if you do the PVC pipe, place a blanket up there or a pillow up there to support your head and neck. You're going to want to spread your feet wider than your knees, and then allow your knees to fall together so that you don't have to use any muscles to hold the legs up. And you want to let your arms rest at your sides and let the fingertips curl up toward the ceiling.
Send him a heart covered as a gift, and hope that you'll take it into her sight. La 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 la
body resting on the floor. Go ahead and wiggle your fingers and toes. And when you're ready, roll over to one.